We're minutes away from President Obama's town hall meeting on health care reform. The policy push comes as Treasury Secretary Geithner urges Congress to raise the national debt limit. According to USA Today, the Congressional Budget Office's latest report on the deficit could be much worse than expected. So given that dire news, can we afford health reform now? Firing off in our power grid, liberal radio host Mike Papantonio and Jack Burkman, attorney at J.M. Burkman and Associates. Mr. Papantonio, let me start with you. You get 20 seconds. You know how it works. Can we not afford to do this now?
Well, we have to do it. Look, teabaggers have put away their teabag Paul Revere outfits, and now they have hospital scrubs on. The hospital scrubs, their outfit this time is being paid for by the insurance industry. Here's why. They want another excuse for why we should do nothing. The first excuse was we're going to turn America into a socialist country. The second excuse is we have two wars to pay for. Here's the truth about deficit. If you really comes right down to it. The truth about... Time's up.
Yeah, 20 seconds. All right.
Shoot.
Mr. Burkman, Jack.
I remember, Michelle, speaking of Larry Summers, when he used to argue for balanced budgets, I guess that's all out the window now. Well, what I say to my liberal friend Mike is, why do we have to do all of this at once? Even for an extreme liberal like Mike, who believes in all of this stuff, health care, TARP, bailout, GM, cash for clunkers, buy up old cars, and God knows what else the U.S. government is doing, why not just pick one or two?
Well, Mr. Papantonio?
Well, here's the truth. Here it is. First of all, the deficit spending issue is a complete red herring. Ronald Reagan created what you look at is debt to GDP ratio. You know that, Jack,
So you want to raise the deficit?
Well, wait, let me finish. Ronald Reagan's debt to GDP ratio was 18%. George Bush Sr.'s was 12%. Let's say everything goes bad for Obama. In the worst scenario, his debt to GDP ratio is going to be 16%.
It's a bad argument, Mike.
That is below the people that you supported for years.
All right, let Mr. Burkman reply to the 18% under Reagan.
It's a bad argument on a number of levels. One is that GDP, the country has just grown, Michelle, so much. But I'll give you the best argument against health care is that let's make some news here. High costs are a good thing. The reason why the price point on the curve is so high is because we have the best drugs in the world. We have the best care in the world.
The price should be high.
That's
Jack,
a good thing. That reflects quality. Every day,
the people who you're lobbying for know this as well as we do. The cost to Americans to do nothing is $200 billion a year that your drug industry and your insurance industry is gobbling up in our health care system.
They're not my drug industry, but I will tell you, the people you're talking about have created the miracle cures that keep these people alive. Let me throw this question out.
No, we're done, Jack. Sorry. Next time around. For the conspiracy theorists out there, we did not make Mr. Papantonio look much smaller on purpose. It was obviously a camera problem. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Michelle.
Good discussion.